about these games that I have to warn you about.
Yes.
The ups and the downs. You're up 30 and it's tied within a second. You're down 30, it's tied within a field, just like that. Know this. This is the best football team in the United States.
So City College of San Francisco is the most successful junior college football program in the history of the United States. We've won more championships, more conference championships. We've scholarshiped more players to every level, but we've in particular scholarshiped more players to the Division I level than any other junior college in the entire country.
We are the winningest college football program in America since 1990.
Our winning percentage since 1990 is over 89%. When you come here, we're gonna create opportunities that you didn't have coming out of high school or coming from your previous college. When you come to City College of San Francisco, a whole new world of opportunities open to you.
Some great, great players here, they got their second opportunity to get themselves into the next level.
There's very few junior colleges where legacy and alma mater pride, so to speak, is as important as it is here. People that play here, they talk about their time at City College, or even more commonly referred to simply as City. There's a lot of City Colleges around the country, but when you say City, people know it's San Francisco.
City College of San Francisco is a very, very special place.
And it's because of the football program and the legacy of the people that have come before.
It has a legacy that goes to all the way to, you know, 75 years plus.
We've had a Heisman Trophy winner. We've had countless players in the NFL, Super Bowl champions. And everyone who comes to City College wants to play here because they want to be a part of the history and the legacy that this program has.
And we have such a diverse team, kids from all kinds of realms, culturally, financially, socially, and they all come together here.
We have a $100 million athletic center that rivals any Division I facility you will find that is less than 10 years old. Every resource you need is here for you to succeed. The legacy is unrivaled, and now you have an opportunity to compete at the highest level of junior college football. Much love from the SFC. Handle bricks in the back of candlestick. Houses for peace. You better grab it. Shield with the cannon. 40 and 50 caliber. Five-time champion. Destroy any challenger. Hit like Mary. Score like Jerry. Still right here. Feel more than Mary. At City College of San Francisco, academics come first. It's student-athlete, not athlete-student.
Well, the process here is very simple. We have a support system that guides a student-athlete from day one on all the way through graduation. We have an academic counselor that's assigned to our athletic department.
We're one of the few junior colleges in the state of California that has an academic advisor who only works with athletes. Her office is in the athletic center across the hall from my office. And she meets only with student athletes, and she understands all the NCAA regulations and transfer rules that a regular counselor on campus is not privy to.
We strive to give our student athletes a second opportunity academically and athletically so they can succeed in life, not just for their college education, but throughout life.
When you come to City College of San Francisco, you know that you're gonna get a chance to play in championship games. You're gonna get a chance to be exposed and promoted to four-year schools like you've never been before.
Everything's set up for success. Anybody that has the will and the work ethic to come in here and get the job done will succeed.
With the academic resources we have, the coaching staff we have, we provide all the support needed to thrive and be able to accept all the new opportunities that are gonna come your way.
In 1969, Paul McCartney and John Lennon wrote this song that is fitting for today. Get back, get back, get back to where you once belonged. Today, City College of San Francisco is trying to get back where they once belonged, the state championship. Will they get there? You'll find out next. Happy Saturday, wherever you may be, and welcome to the Northern California Regional Final here on NorCal Sports TV. College of San Mateo made the 21.4-mile trip up here this morning, a trip that they're very familiar with, to host number one seed City College of San Francisco here at George M. Rush Stadium. I'm Chris Babcock, and thanks for joining us here on NorCal Sports TV. Well, these schools, to say they're familiar with each other would be a big understatement. They first started playing each other in 1936. More recent history, College of San Mateo has won the last two games here against City College. Before that, it had been since 1988, since the Bulldogs have won here at George M. Rush Stadium. So back on November 13th, CCSF held CSM to 36 yards rushing. They blocked a punt. They intercepted quarterback Luke Batari twice to get the win and the number one seed in the Bay Valley Conference, or the Bay Six Championship. These teams, CSM's been playing football since 1920, City College of San Francisco since 1936. So we are expecting one heck of a football game and a little history. Since 2005, City College holds a 9-6 edge. However, before that win in November, CSM had won the last four straight, 2016, 2017, 2018, and 2019. How do I think it's going to be a close game? Well, you've got the two best teams by far, in my opinion, in Northern California. 10 of those 15 matchups have ended up in a score or six or less point differential. Tim Tulloch, the head coach, is in his third season as a head coach, but he's been at CSM for a long time, since 1997. He was the assistant head coach from 2009 to 2017. He's got a career record of 30-5. 2019 led the Bulldogs to the NorCal title. 2018, the NorCal semifinals. Played football at Palomar and graduated from Menlo College. Had a nice visit with him before the game. For the Dons, coached by Jimmy Collins, his sixth season as a head coach, with a record of 53-15, the Rams are looking for their first state bowl championship appearance since 2015, his first season as a head coach here at City College of San Francisco. I'd like to thank our partners who are helping us bring you this game here live on NorCal Sports TV, City College of San Francisco football. Learn more about the 10-time national champion Rams at ccsfathletics.com. City College of San Francisco football, a tradition of winning. Goldmere Restaurant, where the neighborhood goes to make a time out to share classic cocktails and a great meal with family and friends. American Asphalt, taking care of business in Northern California for over 35 years. The Dubliner, West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights and foggier mornings. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 65 years in San Francisco. Stock up for celebrations with family and friends. RVC Showcase, the greatest showcase in the world. Go to rvcshowcase.com and our NCS TV Summer Basketball Camp. So the three keys to victory for the teams after talking with both coaches. I think the most important key for both these teams is managing the emotions. You've got a football game to play. It's not who talks the most or who's the most makes the biggest flamboyant celebration. It's about winning in between the sidelines. First key for CSM, win the turnover battle. They didn't in the last matchup against City College. Win the line of scrimmage. They've got to run the football. The last time they were not very successful running the football, they were 27 attempts for 36 yards rushing. For CCSF, winning first down on defense, special teams, they blocked a punt, but if they plan on kicking the ball to Mr. Lampley, number four, they're really playing with fire, in my opinion. The guy can return punts and kicks and make people look foolish all over the football field. And the final key is be aggressive, be us. That's according to Coach Collins. Those are the keys to victory. So the winner of this game will play the winner of Riverside versus Golden West. That game will be kicking off at the same time. We'll try to keep you updated. And that will be next Saturday down at the Southern California Winners facility. Looks like both teams are about to get on the field. We'll announce the officials. The referee is Jim McHugh. Mike Everett. Everett is the line judge. Field judge is Don Mullins. Back judge, Jeff Bondi. Linesman, John Delgado. Side judge, Jerry Springer. And our umpire is Dave Preciado. And he's got a busy job because both these teams are no-huddle, hurry-up type of offenses. Statistically, you're really looking at the top two defenses overall in the state. CSM is only giving up 260 yards a game. That's third in the state. 103 yards rushing and 157 yards passing. Only giving up 10 points per game. They've had four shutouts and four games are seven or less points. And you can see the Rams about to take the field, as well as the Bulldogs here at George M. Rush Stadium in San Francisco. About a sun has broken through the clouds, and we've got a beautiful day ahead of us of football. Offensively for the Bulldogs, they're 14th in rushing at 75 yards a game, and 29th in passing, just over 220 yards per game. They're averaging nearly 40 points a game. And the Rams, in their red jerseys, take the field. There's going to be a huge crowd. The lunchbox, which has been the concession stand here for years, is opened up today. And it hasn't been like that in 2 years. So the communities are getting together. These are great winning programs. There's going to be a winner. There's going to be a loser. But I think we're all winners when we get done with this historical matchup. I believe it's the only second time they've played in the postseason since 1980. But I don't think there's any bigger game that these schools have ever matched up against each other than today. And we'll just try to stay out of the way and let the players work their magic. We'll take a quick break and then come back. It's the 2021 CCAA Northern California Football Finals on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football. So we're out for the coin flip. The captains, Newman, Weimers, Banks, and Sincere Jackson. And the white jerseys will not be easy to see the numbers today. But we'll do the best. Dylan Juneal, one of the captains. Trey Hines, Luke Batari. Our referee is Jim McHugh. See if we can get the coin flip. The Bulldogs won the toss, and they'll defer. So they'll be kicking off. City College will be getting the ball to start the game. So talk a little bit about the quarterbacks. We'll talk about the quarterbacks and a little bit about the offense after the national anthem. National anthem. So the quarterbacks first for College of San Mateo, number 10, Luke Batari. He is the all-time career touchdown thrower in the history of CSM, number 10, out of Sarah High School. And then quarterbacking for CCSF is Jack Newman, the all-time career thrower, touchdown passes for, and yardage leader at 65 for City College of San Francisco. Placentia will come on to kick. I'm Chris Babcock, and thanks for joining us here on NorCal Sports TV, the streaming home of City College of San Francisco football this postseason. Manage the emotions early. Only a 21-mile drive up here, but if you lose this game, it's a long ride home. If you win, it's a short ride home. Kick taken at about the 8-yard line. Greeley, with the return, leads the state in interceptions, had a pick six last week. And here comes the Rams offense, number 3 overall in the state with 463 yards, second in passing at 319, rushing 144. Third down, they are second at 49%. And they've only turned the football over 11 times. Jeff Weimer, number 80, leads the state in receptions, yardage, and touchdown receptions. Pistol formation for the Dons, or for the Rams, rather. Inside run, missed tackle, and a pickup of about 4 yards by Sean Allen. Allen with 673 yards on the season, 10 touchdowns rushing. It'll be second and 6. And you notice the Rams will flop their offensive linemen depending on direction they're going to run. Zimmerman, the tight end, in motion, and it's inside zone and well played by the Bulldogs defense. And it'll bring up third down and 5. Good job up front. See how much penetration by the white jerseys? And then they just gobble things up. Vaughn Mamea with the tackle. Damari Blanks, the Basics defensive MVP, number 11. We'll be saying his name a lot today. Be 3rd and 5. The CSM defense sacked Newman 4 times in the first matchup. Has time to throw over the middle, and it's complete. That's a tough throw and catch. Rodarty will move the chains. And it'll be 1st down and quick substitutions. Newman sits in that pocket and completes that deep in route in front of Dylan Juneal. 1st and 10 at the 44. Play pass. Taking a shot deep. He's got Weimer. Touchdown, City College of San Francisco. 56 yards to the state's leading receiver. And that's 66 career touchdown receptions or touchdown passes by Jack Newman. Wide open on the deep route. No excuse for that. And the kick is good, and early on, Rams looking to get back to the state championship. There's a positive thing for them. Here's a play one more time. See how much the linebackers suck up. The corner's looking into the backfield, and Weimer takes care of that Linda Ronstadt Blue Bayou coverage, and it's a 56-yard touchdown. The routes, the RVC showcase, the routes versus coverage, RVC showcase is a comprehensive individual and 7-on-7 showcase designed for maximum development, exposure, and fun. Visit the RVC Showcase on Instagram and Twitter at RVC Showcase, or visit them online at rvcshowcase.com. RVC Showcase, the greatest showcase in the world. Didn't take the Rams long to get onto the scoreboard. A little early adversity for the Bulldogs. See how they answer with their first possession of the game. They kick it to Lampley. This doesn't usually end up very good, but pretty good coverage. And he's tackled at the 27-yard line where CSM will take over. Led by quarterback Luke Batari. Bulldogs nearly averaging 400 yards a game, 175 passing, 221, 175 rushing, 221 passing, 39.6 points per game. On third down, they're 16th, but they did not have a good day on third down versus the Rams in the first matchup. One of the keys early for the Rams today is to win first down on defense, and they come up in space and make a tackle on Lampley, his 32nd reception. Quick out and watch the men in red rally up to the football. Scott out of Deer Valley High School. Two tight end look here for the Bulldogs. Pitch out. And the Rams are all over it. Trey Kane with the TFL comes up in space and makes the play. Kane's third tackle for loss. It's third and long. The Bulldogs will break formation. Batari nearly intercepted on that overthrow. Joshua Scott in coverage. And actually was right there to make the play. Batari a little high with this throw. And that's a tough fit because you got Fred Tompkins buzzing that route underneath. Fourth and 13. Holloway calls the fair catch. And the Rams will start off in great field position. First and 10 at their own 46-yard line with 11:31 left in the first quarter. Two-by-one set. Allen behind Newman. Inside run. Pretty well defended there by the Bulldogs. Lavulo, 9 TFLs and 6 sacks. Comes up and forces. Doesn't necessarily make the tackle, but forces that run inside where the Bulldog defense can rally. It's 2nd and 9. No score in the game in Southern California. Nice run. Espero moves the chains on 2nd and 9. There's a little fly pass. Newman will get credit for a completion. And just like that, the Rams are in Bulldog territory. Last week, CSM beat Fresno City College. City College beat American River. Zimmerman in short motion. Inside run. Allen makes a nice job of cutting it back, and then he's met rudely. Malik Johnson stuffs the hole and makes a nice play. But Allen still picks up 4 yards. Zimmerman's out. The Bulldogs will quickly substitute into a dime package. 3-by-1 set. Weimer at the bottom of your screen on an island. Run to Allen. Backside player stays at home. Latu out of Sarah High School makes a nice play. Playing patient along the line of scrimmage, not getting too far upfield. Slow playing it. And it comes and makes the tackle. Well done. 3rd and 5. Rams are 2nd in the state in converting on 3rd down, nearly at 50%. Bulldogs show blitz. Throw downfield, incomplete, off the hands of Reimer. Pretty good coverage out there in space. Trey Hines. Actually, it's Ryan Cooper. No excuse. A uniform from this point, with my old eyes, looks from a 3 to a 5, look like the same number. But the Bulldogs get the stop. CSM calls a timeout. They don't have the right personnel. It's the 2021 NCCAA Northern California Football Finals on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football.
Mirror Restaurant keeps rich in tradition by making its own pastas and desserts. Our classic entrees include veal, homemade pastas, and fresh fish. Located at 800 Terrible Street on the corner of 18th Avenue in San Francisco. The Gold Mirror is open Wednesday through Sunday for dinner and cocktails. Go to goldmirrorsf.com. That's goldmirrorsf.com to learn more about this iconic restaurant that has been serving San Francisco for over 50 years. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant remains a haven from the fast pace of everyday life, where the neighborhood goes to take a time out and share classic cocktails and a great meal with friends and family.
Fourth and 5 after the timeout by the Bulldogs. Corner kick, fair caught, taken at the 10-yard line. Dubliner West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights, foggier mornings. Dubliner West Portal. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 65 years in San Francisco. Stock up for celebrations with family and friends. The Bulldogs will take over on their own 10-yard line, their 2nd possession of the game. Try to establish the run, but not much going there. Sea of red. And in the bottom of that pile will be Mr. Banks. If he gets push, you're going to have a tough time running the football. So, barely a gain for the Bulldogs. And the Rams' DBs, the corners, are pressing on the outside. At some point, especially with Starling out there and his capabilities as a wide receiver, you got to take a couple shots on these guys. They might right here. Holloway's safety is going to help. And then we've got delay a game. So that'll be half the distance. Actually, no, they'll mark this full width of the penalty. So now it'll be 2nd and 14. Mason Starling, 11 touchdowns, fourth in California at the top of your screen. 6'4", big body receiver. Nice throw and catch at a first down for the Bulldogs. Trey Hines slipping inside the defense. Batari looks off, comes back to the weak side, and hits Hines in stride. And the initial first down of the game. Hines' 28th reception of the game of the season. So it'll be a first down. 3-by-1 set. Play pass. Batari. Wide open. Lampley. Tackled at the 45-yard line, but not before gaining 23 yards. And the first explosive play of the game for Coach Tulloch and the Bulldogs. Batari, play pass all day to throw. And the catch by Lampley and getting immediately north up the field. First and 10. It's going to be like this all day long. Short pass out in the flat. Was going to be about a 5-yard gain, but then Starling, his size and physicality takes over, and he picks up an extra 4 yards. Now it's 2nd and 1. The red jerseys better rally up to the football when he's out in the flat, because one guy is not going to bring him down. Watched a lot of film on him this week. 2nd and 1, outside zone, and a shoestring tackle saves a possible touchdown. Ezra Malini. 29 reach, and all the red jerseys are blocked, and just steps and gets north. Inside Ram territory, 1st and 10. Same play, play repeater, and it picks up 3. So remember, in this first matchup back in November, the Bulldogs only rushed for 36 yards. They're working through that stat pretty early here in the first quarter. And both teams have managed the emotions very well. We haven't had any unsportsmanlike, late hits, nothing like that. Clean football. Let's hope that continues. 2nd and 8, Batari, quick throw. And Starling with the catch. Actually, Hines with the catch. He's going one-on-one, Batari trusting the wide receiver, and Hines makes the play. Just a 9 route. It's a 50-50 ball, and Greeley loses that battle. And it'll be a first down at the 12-yard line. CSM started this drive at their own 10 and converted a 3rd and 14. The Rams blitz, throw. Touchdown, Starling, and the Bulldogs. Greeley getting tested, and he's the state's leading interceptor. But the last two plays, the Bulldogs have gone over the top, and this one to Starling, his 12th touchdown reception of the season. It's one-on-one. This is what you love about football. And that's a 50-50 football, and it goes to Starling like it has so many times in his great career. The kick is up, and we're all tied at 7. It's the 2021 CCA Northern California Football Finals on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football.
How was camp for you, Blake?
It was really fun.
What was your favorite part of NorCal Sports TV's summer basketball camp?
The atmosphere. Just being out here, feeling close to nature. Like, I woke up in the morning from getting my award for the 6 a.m. practices. I woke up in the morning, I saw 3 deer just pass by. I got a video. It was really cool. And I love the atmosphere. I love the coaches. I love everybody here. Everybody's here to get better. Everybody's here to have fun. And, you know, I like the competitiveness as well, so.
Eight plays, 90 yards for the Bulldogs. Talking about answering, and a lot of explosive plays in attacking the corner, Greeley, who's been one of the best in the state, but guarding one of the best wide receivers in the state, you got to win those battles. So the Bulldogs will kick off. And that's how you defend. You just kick it out of the end zone. The Rams' second possession of the game from their own 25-yard line. Remember, I believe it was a third and 14 that the Bulldogs converted after a delay of game. And then a number of big plays through the air mostly, but one big run, and we're all tied at 7. The winner of this game will play next Saturday against Riverside Gold or Golden West. See if we can get you a score on that game. Still 0-0. Run along the left side, picks up 3. By Walker. Run a little power play. Second and 7. Newman had a receiver, but Newman paid the price. Lavulo with the hurry. And Newman's been sacked 14 times in the last 4 games. And sometimes your greatest asset can be your biggest negative, meaning sometimes he'll hold and hold and hold. He's been dislodged of the football, was twice last week, 3rd and long, and the Bulldogs will blitz. It's picked up, and it's pass and catch. And a chain moving 1st down, and then some. Another reception. Radardi working his magic over the middle. And that'll be a 1st down. Moving the chains on 3rd down. Newman with a quick throw. I gotcha. Newman once again has Weimer on the shallow cross, doesn't go to him, and he's intercepted. Ryan Cooper Jr. Now, if we go back to that replay, he's got the state's leading receiver on a shallow cross. Weimer is wide open. See number 80 coming through the – he's open. There is no one near him. He throws into triple coverage, and it's an interception. One of the keys for Coach Tolick was to win the turnover battle, and so far they're up +1 on that. 38-yard line, 4:04. Little adversity now for the Rams. See if they test and go to Starling as they did in that last drive. Batari changing the play at the line of scrimmage. Stretch run. J.J. Leahy forces that, and it'll be a TFL. He's all over the football field. That is his 18th tackle for loss this season. Tackle for loss is a tackle behind the line of scrimmage. a negative play, second and 11 for CSM. Play pass, throw out in the flat. The Rams were in pretty good position to make a tackle for no gain, but everybody's grab, and the running back turns up the field and makes a positive gain to make it a very manageable third and 5. There's a missed tackle, and there's a missed tackle. Two missed tackles out in the flat, and a positive play, third and 4 for the Bulldogs. Trying to get points off the turnover. Newman with the interception. Wide open. Hines with the catch. 17 yards. And he is wide open. Not a DB within 5 yards of him. And at this level, with one and two battling out, that's wide open. Boundary run. Positive gain once again for the Bulldogs. So they pick up a couple of yards. It'll be second and 8. But Hines, in that previous play, just a simple vertical route up the field. And he's had a couple of big receptions early on. Second and 8 under the 2-minute mark here from George M. Rush Stadium on the campus of City College of San Francisco. Northern California Regional Final on NorCal Sports TV. Batari scrambles out. Banks has him, does a good job of just playing in front of him, not allowing and losing contain. Banks with some good discipline on the pass rush. More than just a run stopper there, plays with a lot of intelligence and keeps Batari in the pocket and doesn't allow him to scramble for a potential first down. When these teams played back in November, the Bulldogs were only 4 of 12 on third down. They've done well today so far. And then somebody leaves early, surely, and it'll be a procedure. Now, they had a penalty in the last drive that set them up for a third and long, and they executed anyway. This time, Hines, who's having such a great game out of Dublin High School, jumps a little early, and it'll make it third and 13. And the field goal kicker, Placentia, is long as 51 yards this season. One more field goal, and he'll be the all-time leading field goal kicker for a season. Batari under rush. It's a screen. Well executed. And another first down, a 15-yard gain, and a chain-moving play. So I think the Bulldogs were just setting up for a third and extra long. Bellini, once again, just slips, lets the defense get up the field and look at the blocking setup, and he uses the blockers and makes another big gain. Getting nice contributions from deep into the roster today, and that's what you need to do this deep into the season. The winner moves on, the loser goes home. Just under the 1-minute mark here in San Francisco. Stretch run, cutback. And another positive gain on first down. Lee only had 31 carries going into today's game, but today he's already caught a screen pass and has run the football effectively. So it'll be second down and 6. See if the Bulldogs have to run at least one play. Batari got plenty of time to throw. And it's incomplete. He needed to throw that ball on a line versus throwing it with touch, set the feet, and let it go. But the fact that he put air underneath it enabled the defense of the Rams to catch up to the football. He didn't need to leave the pocket, but goes incomplete. So third and six, and so far today, the Bulldogs have fared very well on third down. Third possession of the quarter. Batari out in the flat to Lampley, makes one defender miss, but then everybody else rallies up. Rintizi on the tackle, and it'll be fourth down, but we're going to go to the quarter. We're all tied at seven here from George M. Rush Stadium. Here's that last play, and the Rams do a good job of rallying up. It's the 2021 CCAA Northern California Football Finals on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football. All tied at seven. Placentia trying to break the school record for 14 field goals in a season. He's got 13. This will be a 37-yarder. His long, as I mentioned earlier, is 51. Trying to get points off turnovers off the fourth interception of the season thrown by Newman. The kick is up. And it's good. So points off turnover. The 37-yard field goal by Placentia. And I think when the coaching staff and Jack Newman watch that one on film, they'll see that Weimer on the shallow cross was wide open. But credit the Bulldogs. Now Placentia is now the all-time leading field goal kicker in the season for the Bulldogs. Have been playing nearly 100 years of football. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 65 years in San Francisco. Stock up for celebrations with family and friends. Dubliner, West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks. Foggy nights, foggier mornings. The Dubliner, West Portal. 10-7 Bulldogs, points off of turnover on Newman's only fourth interception of the season. So far, the Bulldogs are winning the turnover ratio. That is only the 12th turnover this season by the Rams. Taken at the 1 yard line, Greeley heads straight up the field and is taken out of bounds at the 25 yard line. Golden West leads Riverside 3-0 with about 10 minutes left in the second quarter. Rams football on their own 25. Zimmerman motion across the formation. Play pass. Newman has got a lot of room to run. And he'll pick up about 8 or 9 yards. Give him 9. So the Bulldogs are in man-to-man coverage. Newman reading the room. Scrambles and picks up a nice gain on first down. It'll be 2nd and 1. Newman scored his first 2 touchdowns of the season last week rushing. Ball in the 39. 2nd and 1. Bulldogs blitz. The Rams do a good job of blocking and picking up the wash. And Walker moves the chains. See all them white jerseys coming upfield, body on a body. Not a big run, but enough to move the chains. 2-by-1 set with a tight end. Weimer at the top of your screen. And he runs a skinny post. And catches the football like he does and gets right up. And it's a lightning play for the Salinas alum. See here, if you wrap up on Weimer, you not only get the initial hit, but then you land on top of him. When you just throw the shoulder, yeah, you'll get right back up. You wrap up on that hit, there might be a whole nother thing. And it's allowed to. It's football. You can't do that out in the streets. Well, you used to not be able to do that out in the streets, but we'll move on. But Weimer with the catch on the Ali McBeal skinny post. 2-by-2 set. Newman is going to go to Weimer. Checks off. It runs the swing route, and he's wide open with room to run. So a lot of times in space today, either team is not doing a very good job of tackling in space. A Sparrow on the swing after the fly motion. And the initial tackler pulling flags doesn't get down the Sparrow, and he moves the chain. So he comes over in motion and fly sweep. Newman looks away on the defense, and the Sparrow picks up an extra 4 yards on the missed tackle. Coach Collins will stay with a 2-by-2 set. Newman down and out to the state's leading receiver, and he'll move the chains once again. Weimer committed to UNLV, a Philo type of guy. First one in, last one out of the locker room. Student of the game, down and out. And a sure tackle in space that time by Latu. 1st and 10. Newman has got the shallow cross. Doesn't throw it. Turns the ball over. It's going to be a hold on CCSF. But Weimer once again, this is the second time he's absolutely wide open on the shallow cross. Newman doesn't throw it to him. By holding it, literally forces the offensive line to hold a little bit longer. But you'll see Weimer, there's no one there. Got to throw him that football. And Newman loses control of the football. Let's see if Coach Tulloch takes it. No, he'll decline the penalty because, and that'll go as a sack against the Rams. So now it'll be 2nd down and 17 on the 7-yard loss by CCSF. 3-by-1 set. Weimer at the bottom of your screen. 1-on-1. 3-man front. Only six players in the box. Newman. Curl route. Complete. Rodarty sits in the zone, and now the Rams will be playing within the chains, and it'll be 3rd down and 8. Savvy receiver just to sit in an open space and not run to another defender. 3rd and 8. Walker behind Newman. In window screen. Not going to get the first down. Rodarte picks up six, maybe seven. And so often with Coach Collins, if the other team gets pressure, they'll come back and run a screen. And here's a screen. Credit the defense of the Ram of the Bulldogs of being into the scout report this week and understanding that these teams are very familiar with themselves. So you're not going to fool them. It'll be a 30-yard field goal attempt by Hill, who's 4 of 7 on the season. Make it 5 of 8, and we're all tied up at 10. It's the 2021 CCAA Northern California Football Finals on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football.
My favorite part was just competing and meeting new people. You know, I'm always with my team, like, practicing in high school. So it was good to come out and meet new people and play against them and get, like, and meet some college coaches.
So, yeah. And the dribbling with the Sacramento Kings coach, that was really fun.
Meeting new people. Making new friends.
Other games. I love playing games, yeah.
Just to be able to practice on my moves.
My favorite part of camp is meeting new people. I've made a lot of friends so far. It's a real great experience here.
A bit too powerful. Okay. 1 second. Has another shot. Puts it up to end the game. Nails the three.
The crowd goes wild.
Here is Shiner
wild.
For three. Yes, look at this. Everyone coming over to congratulate.
Literally, ball in the air as the buzzer went off.
Do you have
Beautiful
the chills?
Finish.
I have the chills.
I definitely
look
got
at that.
The chills.
I got the goosebumps.
I really did too.
10-play drive that took 4 minutes and or 3 minutes and 13 seconds. Short kick. Now that's how you kick directionally kick and keep Lampley out of making an explosive return. So the ball will be spotted. Waiting for the umpire at the 27-yard line. Bulldogs have been balanced today. They've been able to move the ball, throwing and running. Much different than their first matchup in November. Play pass. Batari throws across his body, and it's complete to Starling. And watch him run. About a 46-yard gain for Starling. Batari with the not with the greatest fundamental play throw as a quarterback. But, hey, you got to do what you got to do. Starling is wide open. Makes the catch and then breaks one tackle. Breaks another tackle. And carries another defender down to the 30-yard line. Starling had 14 receptions last week. You got to guard him, and as well as CSM's got to guard Weimer. Starling with the big play. And then the Bulldogs come back with a run to the short side of the field and pick up three. Pretty good push by the Bulldog offensive line. Play pass. Throw out in the flat. It's complete. About an 8 or 9 yard gain, and that'll move the chains once again for CSM. Jalen Lampley with a quick speed cut to the flat, makes the catch, and then gets immediately up the field and moves the chains. Doesn't dance. When you got speed, you don't need to dance. You turn and head south and move the chains, and that's exactly what he did. the Bulldogs inside the red zone. 28 stretch run. A lot of guys like to leap defenders, and boy, there's a result of sometimes when you're not timing that very well. And he's lit up for a short gain, a couple of yards. Evans, when you leap and then met like that, now that's how you wrap up. You get the hit, then you land on top. It's a buy one, get one free. Bulldogs looking to score on their third consecutive drive. Lampley at the bottom of your screen. And they're going to go to him. And no flag. And it'll be third down. Greeley on the coverage. So it'll be third down and 8. Greeley will play about 6 yards off of Starling this time. Batari looks left, out of the pocket, throws across his body, and it's nearly intercepted. See, the previous time he did that, it ended up being a good play. And I said, you don't want to make a living doing that. Then comes back again and nearly on a Saturday throws a pick six. Harold Brooks is right in the coverage. So Placentia on for another field goal attempt. Red zone scoring as far as touchdowns go, the Bulldogs are 31st in the state. It's one of their only negative stats. But Placentia with the field goal. And then we've got a penalty after the play. So a 33-yard field goal. It's a post-play penalty. We'll let the see what the officials are going to call here. He now has 15 field goals this season. He'll continue to add to his record. But that's three straight scores for CSM.
Personal foul, leaping on the defense.
So this, so the field goal, we'll have to cross that off. So Coach Tulloch is not going to take the points. He's going to take the penalty, as I would. And instead of being a three-point game, they'll take points off the board. However, that 15-yard penalty, the ball will be spotted at the 8-yard line. So our first big penalty of the game, and emotions get carried away, and it's the Rams who are guilty. So the Bulldogs will come back out on offense. I would imagine in these first two plays, one of them is going to be a fade route or a back shoulder fade to Starling out here on the right. He's on the 10-yard line guarded by Greeley. Play pass, Batari. Or we just run the crossing route to Starling, and it's an 8-yard touchdown. So it's fake 28 reach, naked left, and Starling comes all the way across the formation for the 8-yard touchdown pass. So Starling's lined up in the right, and he's going to come all the way across the formation, and he's open. And it's an 8-yard touchdown. And the kick is good, and it's 17-10 CSM. Let's watch that play one more time. So the ball's on the right hash. Starling started this play on the television numbers on the right, comes all the way across the formation and gets his second touchdown reception of the game. He now has 13 on the season. And they take advantage of a big penalty by City College. So two touchdown passes by Batari. And it's 17-10. And just a reminder, the Bulldogs won the toss, deferred their selection for the second half. So they'll get the ball to start the third quarter as a 63-yard drive in 2 minutes and 32 seconds. That's how you wrap up. You don't hit a shoulder. You bring the body and you bring the arms. Cruz runs down on special teams. And this is what a form tackle is. Didn't bring the shoulder. He brought the shoulder and the entire body and wrapped up. So 7:59 here. And CCSF will take over, and they need to answer. All the momentum right now is with the Bulldogs. Two by one set. Zimmerman as a wing. Slot blitz shown by CSM. And that play is going nowhere. I think there was a little confusion in the backfield. Lavallo with another play in the backfield. That's his 10th TFL of the season. A little problem with the footwork in the backfield. And credit the Bulldog defense of getting up the field. Second and 11. Zimmerman in motion. Edge blitzer, throwback against the. And then we're going to. That'll be called grounding there or an illegal man downfield. That penalty will be on CCSF, not on the Bulldogs. The Bulldogs with a zone blitz, which fooled the offense of the Rams. And this is a loss of down. And it's a spot foul of wherever he threw the football. So there's the blitz. They throw into the blitz, but who does a good job there is an inside linebacker of keying his guard. So it'll be a loss of down. So it'll be third down and 11. When you are so familiar with each other, you got to do some new things. And a nice blitz and pickup by the Bulldogs. Newman has time to throw. Deep in route, and it's a first down. That's a college throw for a first down right down the center of the field. Zone coverage right under the backers and in front of the safeties. And it's a first down. 3-by-1 set. Weimer all by himself at the top of the screen with no safety help. Allen picks up 5. The winner of this game will play the winner of Riverside and Golden West. Golden West leads that game 3-0. I'm Chris Babcock. Thanks for joining us here on NorCal Sports TV, the streaming home of City College of San Francisco football this postseason. Newman with the throw and getting his hands Sakai Asoa-Ofoa. This is what you do as a pass rusher if you can't get there. You read the action of the quarterback. I'm not going to get there, but I'm going to get my hands up. And makes a nice play and gets the knockdown. So it'll be third down and 5. You don't necessarily have to get a sack as a defensive lineman to make an impact on a play, and that was an example. Third down. Little amoeba front here. Now they'll get, look like they're going to get an edge blitzer. Newman has time. Throw to the flat. We've got a penalty. I believe it's going to be a hold. This one's coming back. And possibly could be a post and chop. No, it's a hold on the Rams. So it'll be third and 15. So right in the center of the field, pressure up by the Bulldogs causes the Rams to get handsy. It'll be third down now and 15. Six-minute mark here from San Francisco. Newman, deep ball. He's got a receiver. And it's complete. And then I believe we've got sideline interference, or it's going to be a sideline warning. That's a 35-yard dime for a first down on third and 15. Here's the call. Newman. Another 50-50 ball. This one goes to the Rams. It's a sideline warning. The thing about warnings, it's like warnings, you have a warning like the first day of school or the first game of the season. When it's week 12 or week 13, the warning should be done. The coaches ought to know to stay out of that running lane for the officials. I'll get off my soapbox. It'll be first and 10. For the Rams, they'll stay with that 3-by-1 set. Newman checking the play at the line of scrimmage. Runs 29 reach. Allen. Down to the 10. 30-yard gain. Back-to-back explosive plays for the men in red. This simple 29-reach zone blocking and nice push up front by the Rams' offensive line. Body on body, little pick, little pin and pull, and it's very effective. Allen down to the 10. Newman gets the play to Weimer. They get closer to the goal line. They'll go an unbalanced set play pass. Newman, end zone, incomplete. Rodarty was the intended receiver. Blanket coverage there in the end zone by Dillon. Fifteen on the play clock. Second and 10. Newman has time. Corner route. Touchdown, City College of San Francisco. Espero on the corner route. And that's a dime by Newman. 83-yard drive with a lot of explosive plays for the Rams. Hill kick is good. Let's watch that one more time. Simple corner route. Out route outside. But that's how you throw that pass. Espero. RVC Showcase. The routes versus coverage is a comprehensive individual and 7-on-7 showcase designed for maximum development, exposure, and fun. Visit the RVC Showcase on Instagram and Twitter at RVC Showcase, or visit them online at rvshowcase.com. RVC Showcase, the greatest showcase in the world. So more ebb and flows here from San Francisco, where the Bulldogs had the Rams on third and long a couple of times that Newman was able to take care of business, and then Espero with the 8-yard touchdown. Short kick. And Hines cannot return it as the Rams special teams sprinting up the field. So the Bulldogs will take over. That was a 3-minute and about a 3-minute drive for the Rams. The Bulldogs will take over on their own 25. They'd like to do is go down and score, evaporate the clock, and then get the ball to start the second half. 28 reach. We've got a hold on CSM, and this will be marched back. So both quarterbacks have thrown 2 touchdown passes, and both kickers have kicked a field goal. Starling at the bottom of your screen as the X receiver. First down and 20, play pass. Batari out here in the flat. These guys leaping each other. Their insurance rates are going to go through the roof. 6-yard gain. Look at 11 run out in space and finish there. Brooks playing with a lot of passion. It's 2nd and 14. The Bulldogs have scored in their last 3 possessions. Batari to Starling. That's how you close on a football. Trey Kane playing in space. This time, when the ball's in the air, he doesn't go for the kill shot. He makes a nice hit and dislodges the football from Starling, but hits him low, doesn't target up to the helmet, and makes a play with the pass defense. Kane understanding and making adjustments. Here's another look at it on the vertical route, and Kane closing and wrapping versus just popping with the shoulder. 3rd and 14. Batari, shallow cross. It'll be the first down. Murphy on the in route. Great job by Batari of taking the defense deep and coming back and hitting the in route. Look at, he's looking deep. Then he runs that shallow cross, gets immediately up the field. When he's steering the defenders downfield, they're sinking and sinking and sinking. It gives the opportunity for the third and long conversion. First and 10 on the 36. Zone run. We've got two players that lost their helmets on the play. They'll have to come out and sit out for one play. One's Fred Tompkins, the linebacker, and Ames, one of the offensive linemen. He'll have to come out for a play. It'll be second down and 7. The player already had to come out because his helmet got knocked off, but then I think the coaches told him to take a knee, which he did. Want to thank our partners helping us bring you this game today. City College of San Francisco football. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant, where the neighborhood goes to take a time out to share classic cocktails and a great meal with family and friends. American Asphalt, taking care of business in Northern California for over 35 years. Dubliner, West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights, foggier mornings. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 65 years in San Francisco. Stock up for the holidays, celebrations with family and friends. So it'll be 2nd and 7 for CSM. Starling at the top of your screen, actually at the bottom of your screen, guarded by Greeley. Play pass, Batari, it's got time. Brooks trying to rush, thrown, it's incomplete. So I think there could be a couple of penalties. One of them could be an illegal cut block on the offensive line of CSM. The other call could be grounding. So we'll see what is called, because the offensive lineman for CSM came back and blocked towards his own goal line. Watch this at the bottom of your screen. Right there. That could be an illegal chop block, and then there's nobody, no illegal man down, no receiver within sight. Yeah, it was a chop block. So that's anytime you're running back towards, you're not running towards your end zone, you're going towards the opponent's end zone and you block, that's going to be the call. But hey, CSM has done fantastic on third down and second down and long, so they're not worried about it. Shovel pass, little screen, and JJ Leahy traces his steps and makes the tackle. So it'll be 3rd down and 17. Little screen, which was successful earlier in the game. But 3rd and 17, CSM not worried. And we've got a timeout. They've executed a number of 3rd and longs today to move out from their own end zone, get out of positions where you thought they were going to be punting. They've been successful, and it just hasn't been Starling. They've had other receivers compete, but he's been there to make the big touchdown catches. See if we can give you, while we've got a break, is the score down in Southern California. I believe they're all tied at 3. Yes, they are. And that game is at halftime. So the winner of this game will play down in Southern California next Saturday. But we've got a lot of game left here. And it's gonna, when this game ends, we're going to wish it can continue to be played, just because the talent and passion of these two schools and programs. 3rd and 17. Late blitz, post route, Starling. As I said it prior, actually, Starling not on the reception, Murphy on the reception. Just a deep post route, and he is open on the Allie McBeal skinny post. Gets inside the defender and then diagonally cuts across the field and moves the chains. And the wide receiver, first rule, first thing of the day is to watch the football. The ball doesn't move, but he does, and it's a 5-yard penalty. I believe that's the second time Hines has done that today. But every time it seems like CSM has had an offensive penalty, they've come back and answered. So they've kept their composure. Batari, under duress, throws it. Intercepted! You can't throw that one up for grabs, and that's exactly what they did. Kedonga! This one is just dripping with gravy just after the Thanksgiving holiday. Throw this in the 12th row, not to the sideline. Batari with the errant throw, and it's a first turnover of the game by CSM. So 1:26 left. The Rams have two timeouts. And that is a huge play. That one, set your feet and just throw it into the bleachers. That is the 19th interception this season by CCSF. Newman, time, throw, complete. Catch first, run second. And young receivers watching at home, if you catch the football with your eyes, your hands will never drop it. But as soon as you take your eyes off the football, which is an example right here, and you're looking upfield, that's what's going to happen. Incomplete. It'll be second and 10. 1:21 left here in the second quarter. 2-by-2 set. Newman. Twist up front by the Bulldogs. Weimers. I don't think he has enough to get the first down. Yes, he does. All right, run a 10-yard out. Well, that was an exact 10-yard out. Twist up front by the Bulldogs. Good job by the Rams picking that up. And the state's leading receiver moves the chains. The Rams try to get points off a turnover, the interception. 2-by-2 set. Newman throws it in traffic and goes incomplete. Wasn't a good decision. Throwing into double coverage late can only have bad things. He's got the slot receiver, Rodarte, wide open. But goes to his favorite receiver, and it goes incomplete. Second and 10. Three-man rush. Hits Rodarte for a 5-yard, about a 3-yard reception after it's spotted. It'll be third down and 7. Newman. Intercepted! Janiel. As the Bulldogs play complimentary football, the defense picks up the offense. Janiel reading the eyes of Newman. He had only had 4 interceptions going into this game. This is his second interception of the half. Not a good decision. Janiel with the pick. And instead of getting points off a turnover, they're giving the Bulldogs a chance to get points off a turnover. Janiel with the pick. Reading the eyes of the quarterback. And the field goal kicker, Placentia, he's hit a 51-yarder this season. Then Brooks gets home. So the defense stepping up here, and Brooks with the big sack. 10-yard loss. Watch 11 just force his will. And I think the Bulldogs are just going to let this one. Surprised that Coach Collins isn't calling a timeout. And that'll be halftime. We'll be tied at 17. So the Bulldogs will get the ball to start this second half. So let's give you a quick recap of the first half. 56-yard touchdown reception by Weimer made it 7-0. And then Batari to Starling tied it up at 7. Placentia with his school record 14th field goal of the season makes it 10-7. Then Hill answered with his own 31-yard field goal. Then Batari to Starling after Placentia made the field goal, personal foul on CCSF. Coach Tolick doesn't take he takes the penalty. And they take advantage to make the score 17-10. Then Newman to Aspero for 8 yards and tied it up at 17. It's the 2021 CCAA Northern California Football Finals on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people. Because I thought there's going to be like very little people here from all around here. But there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far. And, you know, just got to meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it.
City College of San Francisco is the most successful junior college football program in the history of the United States. We've won more championships, more conference championships. We've scholarshiped more players to every level, but we've in particular scholarshiped more players to the Division I level than any other junior college in the entire country.
We are the winningest college football program in America since 1990.
Our winning percentage since 1990 is over 89%. When you come here, we're going to create opportunities that you didn't have coming out of high school or coming from your previous college. When you come to City College of San Francisco, a whole new world of opportunities open to you.
Some great, great players here. They got their second opportunity to get themselves into the next level.
There's very few junior colleges where legacy and alma mater pride, so to speak, is as important as it is here. People that play here, they talk about their time at City College, or even more commonly referred to simply as City. There's a lot of City Colleges around the country, but when you say City, people know it's San Francisco.
City College of San Francisco is a very, very special place.
And it's because of the football program and the legacy of the people that have come before.
It has a legacy that goes all the way to, you know, 75 years plus.
We've had a Heisman Trophy winner. We've had countless players in the NFL, Super Bowl champions. And everyone who comes to City College wants to play here because they want to be a part of the history and the legacy that this program has.
And we have such a diverse team, kids from all kinds of realms, culturally, financially, socially, and they all come together here.
We have a $100 million athletic center that rivals any Division I facility you will find that is less than 10 years old. Every resource you need is here for you to succeed. The legacy is unrivaled, and now you have an opportunity to compete at the highest level of junior college football.
Much love from the SFC. Handle bricks in the back of candlestick. Houses for peace. You better grab it. Shield for the cannon. 40 and 50 caliber. Five-time champion. Destroy any challenger. Hit like Barry. Score like Jerry. Skill right here. Feel more than Mary.
At City College of San Francisco, academics come first. It's student-athlete, not athlete-student.
Well, the process here is very simple. We have a support system that guides a student-athlete from day one on all the way through graduation. We have an academic counselor that's assigned to our athletic department.
We're one of the few junior colleges in the state of California that has an academic advisor who only works with athletes. Her office is in the athletic center across the hall from my office. And she meets only with student athletes, and she understands all the NCAA regulations and transfer rules that a regular counselor on campus is not privy to.
We strive to give our student athletes a second opportunity academically and athletically so they can succeed in life, not just for their college education, but throughout life.
When you come to City College of San Francisco, you know that you're gonna get a chance to play in championship games. You're going to get a chance to be exposed and promoted to four-year schools like you've never been before.
Everything's set up for success. Anybody that has the will and the work ethic to come in here and get the job done will succeed.
With the academic resources we have, the coaching staff we have, we provide all the support needed to thrive and be able to accept all the new opportunities that are going to come your way.
The Gold Mirror Restaurant keeps rich in tradition by making its own pastas and desserts. Our classic entrees include veal, homemade pastas, and fresh fish. Located at 800 Terrivol Street on the corner of 18th Avenue in San Francisco. The Gold Mirror is open Wednesday through Sunday for dinner and cocktails. Go to goldmirrorsf.com. That's goldmirrorsf.com to learn more about this iconic restaurant that has been serving San Francisco for over 50 years. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant remains a haven from the fast pace of everyday life, where the neighborhood goes to take a time out and share classic cocktails and a great meal with friends and family.
How was camp for you, Blake?
It was really fun.
Yeah. What was your favorite part of NorCal Sports TV's summer basketball camp?
The atmosphere. Just being out here, feeling close to nature. Like, I woke up in the morning from getting my award for the 6 a.m. practices. I woke up in the morning, I saw three deer just pass by. I got a video. It was really cool. And I love the atmosphere. I love the coaches. I love everybody here. Everybody's here to get better. Everybody's here to have fun. And, you know, I like the competitiveness as well, so.
The Gold Mirror Restaurant keeps rich in tradition by making its own pastas and desserts. Our classic entrees include veal, homemade pastas, and fresh fish. Located at 800 Terrible Street on the corner of 18th Avenue in San Francisco. The Gold Mirror is open Wednesday through Sunday for dinner and cocktails. Go to goldmirrorsf.com. That's goldmirrorsf.com to learn more about this iconic restaurant that has been serving San Francisco for over 50 years. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant remains a haven from the fast pace of everyday life, where the neighborhood goes to take a time out and share classic cocktails and a great meal with friends and family.
My favorite part was just competing and meeting new people. You know, I'm always with my team, like practicing in high school, so it was good to come out and meet new people and play against them and get like and meet some college coaches.
So, yeah. And the dribbling with the Sacramento Kings coach, that was really fun.
Meeting new people, making new friends.
Other games, I love playing games. Yeah.
Just to be able to practice on my moves.
My favorite part of camp is meeting new people. I've made a lot of friends so far. It's a really great experience here.
A bit too powerful. 1 second. Has another shot. Puts it up to end the game. Nails the three.
The crowd
Gary Shiner
wild.
For three. Yes, look at this. Everyone coming over to congratulate.
Literally ball in the air as the buzzer went off.
Do you have
Beautiful
the chills?
Finish.
I have the chills.
I definitely
look
got the chills.
Look at that. I got the goosebumps.
I really did too.
What's your favorite part of this camp so far?
My favorite part is meeting new people, such as teammates and old friends that came earlier.
I really like the one-on-one training. The coaches really tried to get like the connections with the kids during the camp, so I think that was a really good part of it.
I liked the drills, the ball handling drills, and shooting drills.
I think, you know, one thing that's very underrated here at the camp was like meeting new people. Because I thought there was going to be, like, very little people here from all around here. But there's people from Oakland, there's people from Atascadero, way far, and, you know, just got to meet new people. I really liked it. I was enjoying it. It was really fun.
Down 30 high within a second. You know this. This is the best football team in the United States.
So City College of San Francisco is the most successful junior college football program in the history of the United States. We've won more championships, more conference championships. We've scholarshiped more players to every level, but we've in particular scholarshiped more players to the Division I level than any other junior college in the entire country.
We are the winningest college football program in America since 1990.
Our winning percentage since 1990 is over 89%. When you come here, we're going to create opportunities that you didn't have coming out of high school or coming from your previous college. When you come to City College of San Francisco, a whole new world of opportunities open to you.
Some great, great players here, they got their second opportunity to get themselves into the next level.
There's very few junior colleges where legacy and alma mater pride, so to speak, is as important as it is here. People that play here, they talk about their time at City College, or even more commonly referred to simply as City. There's a lot of City Colleges around the country, but when you say City, people know it's San Francisco.
City College of San Francisco is a very, very special place.
And it's because of the football program and the legacy of the people that have come before.
It has a legacy that goes all the way through, you know, 75 years plus.
We've had a Heisman Trophy winner. We've had countless players in the NFL, Super Bowl champions. And everyone who comes to City College wants to play here because they want to be a part of the history and the legacy that this program has.
And we have such a diverse team, kids from all kinds of realms, culturally, financially, socially, and they all come together here.
We have a $100 million athletic center that rivals any Division I facility you will find that is less than 10 years old. Every resource you need is here for you to succeed. The legacy is unrivaled, and now you have an opportunity to compete at the highest level of junior college football.
Much love from the SFC. Handle bricks in the back of candlestick. Houses for peace. You better grab it. Shield with a candy. 40 or 50 caliber. Five-time champion. Destroy any challenger. Hit like Barry. Score like Jerry. Skill right. Can't feel more than
17 all here at halftime. George M. Rush Stadium on the campus of City College of San Francisco. Turnovers have been the story, one by CSM Batari with a bad throw that was intercepted out in the flat, but then Newman of City College of San Francisco came in the game with only three interceptions. He's thrown two picks in the second quarter. We're all tied at 17. The first score of the game, 56. Play pass. We're on the play pass. And he's wide open and walks in for the score. But then Batari to Starling on the 50-50 ball. And Starling showing his ability, beating Greeley, who had good coverage. and here's the play pass, and another throw to Starling comes all the way across the formation with the score. Here's another look at it, and that's a tough throw and catch, and Starling with a second touchdown of the game. Then Newman with the corner route, and that's completed for another touchdown to Aspero. And here's Batari again. Actually, that's last week against American River, and Greeley's pick six. We're going to make Jason write 100 sentences. I will not show last week's highlights. That's all right. All right, so we're tied at 17. CSM won the toss. They deferred their choice to the second half. So they'll get the opening kick. They've done a good job so far of not kicking the ball directly to Lampley. They've been directionally kicking, and that's paid off. And they'll do another directional kick that'll land right around the 30 and a return upfield to the 38-yard line. And the Bulldogs will start with pretty good field position. On the 39-yard line, will they'll start their drive. I'm Chris Babcock. Thanks for joining us here on NorCal Sports TV, the streaming home of City College of San Francisco football this postseason. Appreciate all of our partners, which have allowed us to bring you this game. All we ask is subscribe to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/NorCalSportsTV. First and 10, three wide receiver set. Batari, little sit route to Lampley, and he'll move the chains, and it'll be a 15-yard gain. So one of the keys to the game was to win the battle on first down, and on that play, CSM with the little sit route, Lampley gets up the field and gets the first down. Winning on first down on defense, special teams, and be aggressive, be us. That was CCSF's keys to the game. For CSM, win the turnover battle, win the line of scrimmage, and championship execution. A run Bellini picks up a couple. It'll be second and 8. Just the start here of the third quarter. Winner goes to the state championship next Saturday. Blitz, bootleg. Throw out to the flat, and it's a completed pass and gets about 6 yards. That play, Batar did a good job of getting his head around immediately because there was an edge blitzer that came unblocked right off the edge. And Batar does a good job of getting it out to the flat and picking up positive yardage. Landfear, the tight end, with the catch in a very manageable third and short for the Bulldogs. Do they audible, thinking they're going to go for it on fourth down and throw a fade route to Starling? They don't. Run to the wide side of the field. We've got a hold. This one's coming back. Evans with the touchdown run, but this one's coming back. And we've got a hold on the Bulldogs. Big pile of mess in the front, and then a takedown. And that's an easy call. And nullifies the 38-yard touchdown run. And it'll be third and a long 12, which has not been a problem for CSM today. They've converted a number of third and longs when they're behind the chains. So it'll be Third and 12 here. Rams with some substitution. They'll go with their dime defense. 2x2 set. The Bulldogs have been able to take advantage of the middle of the field on these third and longs. Batari, they'll try to run. And Rantizzi was there to wrap up, made a great decision of not trying to vault and hit Batari. Credit Batari for being heads up and not getting greedy, just picking up the yards that he deserved and making it a manageable fourth down. This season, CSM is 8 of 16 on fourth down. My Chico State math says that's 50%. This is their first fourth down attempt of the game. Probably go with a long count, maybe try to draw the Rams off sides. Batari, slant route, in and out of the hands. Wide open receiver. Lampley, I believe, on the in route. Didn't really need to jump. And when you jump, what happens is that your eye level changes. And when you jump, a lot of times that's the result. So the fourth down stop is big for CCSF. Right there, that little leap, it changes the eye level of the football. Newman, Allen, picks up three on first down. So although that is not an official turnover, it is a turnover on downs. And now the Rams trying to take advantage. Weimer, bottom of your screen, he's had a couple of big explosive plays today. Flat route, complete. That's great. I know the youngsters out here don't know what a phone booth is, but this right here, a Sparrow wins the one-on-one in the phone booth. He looks like this is going to be a few-yard completion, right? Right there in the phone booth. Mooses one, makes another miss, and gets up the field. Third down and two. The Rams are one of the best converting third down teams in the state. Fly sweep, shovel pass, and it goes nowhere. Matter of fact, it's a TFL. Let's see what the Rams do here. Do they go for it or do they punt? Nice defense playing flat along the line of scrimmage. Watch the white jerseys up top. Force and then come up and close with the tackle. So it'll be fourth and two. The Rams will send out their punt team. Got to be careful here. Only the third punt for either team. Lampley catches it, gets a short return, about a four-yard gain. RVC Showcase, the routes versus coverage. RVC Showcase is a comprehensive individual and 7-on-7 showcase designed for maximum development, exposure, and fun. Visit the RVC Showcase on Instagram and Twitter at RVC Showcase or visit them online at www.rvcshowcase.com. RVC Showcase, the greatest showcase in the world. So both teams have one possession in the third quarter. CSM gets the stop and will take over on their own 18. This run is going nowhere. However, great vision by Evans of cutting back against the grain and picking up 7 yards. Right here, Banks and company have that walled off, but the backside doesn't stay at home. Evans cuts back and picks up a huge gain when it was going to be no gain. Second and three. Evans loses yardage here. The first time we've said his name, didn't play last week. Fred Tompkins, recently committed to UNLV, gets the TFL. And instead of making it was going to be third and short, is now going to be third and seven. Tompkins with the TFL. Score down south. Both teams have exchanged touchdowns. It's 10-10. Riverside at Golden West. Batari under pressure throws, and it's incomplete. There's no one out here. That's going to be grounding. But watch Banks, the big fella, just plowing upfield and pushing the offensive lineman towards Batari. C-98, wham! You can't block him with a running back. Are you kidding me? That's the result. And Batari thrown off his back foot, and it goes incomplete. Banks is the kind of guy, when he comes in the door, he's got to turn his shoulders because he's so wide. Mr. Banks, nice play there. Didn't get the sack, but he got the hurry. CSM with their second punt of the game. Kick goes, and it's caught on the run, and about a 7-yard return by Holloway. And CCSF will take over in great field position on the 42-yard line of the Bulldogs. And what does Coach Collins like to do in these situations? He loves to go deep. Weimer's at the top of your screen. And three receivers at the bottom. Three-man front for the Bulldogs. Walker keeps moving his feet, and watch this mass move. 6-yard gain on first down to kind of calm the storm a little bit in this big football game here in San Francisco. Stretch run. The Bulldogs had a chance to make a play in the backfield. Leakio had a chance, but he could not make the play. Worked his hands to come off the blocker, but then couldn't finish the play. Bulldogs showing blitz. Bubble screen out here. And Rock'em Sock'em Robots. A Sparrow showing a lot of toughness. Will move the chains. Weimer with a block out here in space on the bubble screen. And it's a first down. A Sparrow right there. Breaks the tackle. Moves the chains. First and 10 on the 30. Reach. Walker picks up 5. Effective runs. It's just zone blocking. Edge guys are responsible for the backer, and then it's a little pin and pull with the guard pulling around as the tackle pins. Thus the pin and pull. Little area blocking. Second and 5. The whole playbook is open at this point. Walker showing fresh legs and picks up 11 and moves the chains. Give him 12. We love play repeaters, play repeaters. There's a 28 reach once again. Little pin and pull, and Walker. And look at the Weimers showing his selflessness out there in space, blocking. 2x2 set. Bulldogs trying to get a stop in the red zone. Newman, screen to Craffenried, and he is sharked. Sinclair comes up with rude intentions on the middle screen and picks up, gets to the original line of scrimmage. See, look at the discipline by the white jerseys. Knowing how much of a big screen team the Rams are, those the defensive linemen feel that they're not getting rushed, so they retrace their steps and run down the line of scrimmage. 58 sprint by Newman. Complete. Kid just keeps running. Picks up 9, maybe 8 yards. And Ridardi once again with the catch. Clock's running. So it'll be 3rd and 1. Now, just don't be sure that City College is just going to run the football here. They might play pass and go into the end zone, knowing they might go for it on 4th down. Zimmerman coming in as a fullback slash tight end. DeCraffenried will close his split and then timeout Coach Collins before the delay of game. Dubliner, West Portal. So many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights, foggier mornings. The Dubliner, West Portal. Mitchell's Ice Cream. I've been going there since 1989 when I worked for Pepsi in San Francisco. What a great place. Celebrating over 65 years in San Francisco. Stock up for the holiday celebrations with family and friends. Mitchell's Ice Cream. So Coach Collins, there was a little confusion on the play call. So instead of taking a possible bad play and making it even a worse play, he calls the timeout as the play clock was about to expire. It would have been a 5-yard penalty. So once again, the winning team here will be the NorCal champion. They'll travel next Saturday down to Southern California to take on the winner of Riverside versus Golden West. And those teams, now Riverside is ahead 17-10. Just the start of the 4th quarter. 3rd down and short. This was going to be a halfback pass, I believe. I believe it was going to be a halfback pass. And the only reason I say that is that Weimer, instead of blocking, looked like he ran inside and was going to the corner. Yep, that was going to be a halfback pass. But the Bulldogs doing a good job of staying at home and guarding the state's leading receiver. So they do a great job defensively. Hill, the kick, it's up, and it's good. But credit CSM for holding him to a field goal versus a touchdown. It's the 2021 CCCAA Northern California Football Finals on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football.
Mirror Restaurant keeps rich in tradition by making its own pastas and desserts. Our classic entrees include veal, homemade pastas, and fresh fish. Located at 800 Terrible Street on the corner of 18th Avenue in San Francisco. The Gold Mirror is open Wednesday through Sunday for dinner and cocktails. Go to goldmirrorsf.com. That's goldmirrorsf.com to learn more about this iconic restaurant that has been serving San Francisco for over 50 years. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant remains a haven from the fast pace of everyday life, where the neighborhood goes to take a time out and share classic cocktails and a great meal with friends and family. Mirror Restaurant keeps rich in tradition by making its own pastas and desserts.
So credit the Bulldog defense. It was 3rd and 1 There was a little confusion by the Rams offense. They called the timeout, and then they went to their, although it's December, they went a little trickeration, but the Bulldog defense covered Weimer, and they weren't able to get off the pass, and it was a loss, and only a field goal attempt. Starling fumbles the punt or the kick, and it's going to be Ram football, I believe. Actually recovered by CSM. Starling was trying to do something with the football. Instead of just catching it, hits right off his face mask. But somehow that is recovered by CSM. And they dodge a big, big bullet there. So they'll take over on their own 26. 2017, play pass. So it'll be a screen, little act pass out to the flat, and I believe we've got a face mask on the tackle by Tompkins. Page with the reception, and we'll see what the call is. I love when you fake to a running back and throw back to him. And you know, was the first coach who ever did that was Bill Walsh. And I know Julian Edelman goes down as one of the top players, Super Bowl champion, to come out of CSM. But two great Bay Area coaches, the two all-time football coaches in Bay Area history, John Madden and Bill Walsh, played at CSM, and also Dick Vermeil coached at CSM. And it's funny, there they on that completion. Fake it to the running back, throw back to him. Tompkins with the face mask, and CSM with the stop in the red zone to force the field goal. Now we're nearly in Ram territory. Page showing some fresh legs and picks up 8 on the run. So it'll be second down and short. The emotions of both teams, both coaching staffs have done a great job today controlling that. It's been very good, clean football from the start to where we are right now. Batari, push off. Starling, doesn't matter, goes complete. The physical wide receiver. They're going to let you get away with it. You got to do it. Starling. With 11-yard reception, showing his physicality. Top of the screen. Little push off, getting some separation from Joshua Scott. Page is met rudely by Fred Tompkins in the hole. So the one previous in the first half had been a run to the bench and then a cutback. Well, this time when they cut back, one of the state's best linebackers is there to wrap up and finish right there and brings his feet with the wrap. 2nd and 9. That's what tackling is. Wrapping up and bringing your opponent to the ground. 2nd and 9, near the 3-minute mark in the third quarter. Fly sweep, chicken strip, ball's loose, and it stays with CSM. J.J. Leahy, where he lives, is in the opponent's backfield with another TFL. Watch 47, plays along the line of scrimmage, and then punches out the football. 3rd and 12. So many times today, CSM has been behind the chains and has got the first down. One of these times, the Rams will have to make a play. CSM has been making the plays consistently on 3rd and long. Shallow cross, and then a post right behind it, and that's a dart for a first down. So it's a shallow cross, but then behind that, Dixon Veal, and then we've got a hold, and this will come back. Great combination, layered routes. You've got a deep in or a shallow cross and then a post route coming behind, but it all goes for naught on that quick throw by Batari is a hold. And that'll nullify that play. So the ball will be spotted at the 45. It'll be third and 22. If you're Batari here, you don't want to force the football. If you have to punt and force, you're in a, it's a one-score game. Batari throws a shallow cross, and look at the Rams rally to the football. Hold it to a 7-yard gain. Will they go for it on fourth down? Is it four down territory? Looks like they'll bring on the punt team, but you got to play this one honest. The Rams probably play a punt safe and not turn their back to the kicker. Fourth and 15. Nine punts inside the 20 this season. And this one will be at the 11-plus yard line. Well, they'll take over. .123 left. RVC Showcase. The greatest showcase in the world. Go to rvcshowcase.com. Newman will bring on the offense. 12-yard line, 1:23 left in the quarter. Up by a field goal. Bulldogs have a +1 turnover ratio today. 28 reach, cutback. Walker. Fumbles. The official call him down. But Walker, that's fine if you want to cut back, but if you cut back, you're cutting back right into the teeth of the defense, and you better hold on that football. Cuts back, and then watch the hands right there. And he was down. Good call. Newman, flat route, complete, first down. Aspero. His middle name on his in his resume is Chain Mover. That's all he has done today, and that's a big pickup for the Rams. Last 30 seconds of the quarter. Newman, 58 sprint, sets his feet and makes a great decision of just getting positive yardage instead of trying to be a hero, because the Bulldogs had coverage blanketed that time, and if he'd thrown it would have been his third interception of the game. Clock's running, second and 7. See if the Rams run a play. They do. Walker. He'll pick up the first burst of speed right there by Walker. Probably was the Rams will run another play. Newman paid the price. Licchio with rude intentions with the hurry. And that's the end of the third quarter. City College of San Francisco, 20. College of San Mateo, 17. Who will survive and move on to next week's state final? Well, you'll find out next. You're watching the 2021 CCCA Northern Cal Football Finals on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football. College, was it on their own 8-12? RVC Showcase, the routes versus coverage. RVC Showcase is a comprehensive individual and 7-on-7 showcase designed for maximum development, exposure, and fun. Visit the RVC Showcase on Instagram and Twitter at RVC Showcase, or visit them online at rvcshowcase.com. RVC Showcase, the greatest showcase in the world. 2nd and 10 for the Rams. Fifteen on the play clock. 3-by-1 set. Weimer at the top of your screen. Newman got all day to throw out here in the flat. And good job, Janiel, just playing out in the flat, not trying to go for the kill shot, just making the tackle, and it's a short gain, maybe 1 yard. It'll be 3rd and 9. Watch Janiel break down in space, use the sideline as an extra tackler, and makes the play. Well done. 3rd and 9. 2-by-2, actually an empty back. This is the first time the Rams have gone empty today. Empty backfield means the quarterback is all by his lonesome. Bulldogs showing blitz. They don't blitz. Throw to DeCaffenried, makes the catch, but he only gets about 4 yards, and it'll be 4th down. And the Rams will bring on their punt team. Good job by the Bulldog defense. They gave up some yards as that drive started on their own 12. But on 3rd down and long, they do a good job of tackling and playing in space. Lachlan, the punter, taken at the 21-yard line, and well done by the special teams. Jared Wade getting down there and making the play. CSM's football on their own 21-yard line, trailing by 3. These schools have been playing each other since 1936. And CSM has won their last 2 here at George M. Rush Stadium, looking trying to make it a 3rd in a row. City with a 3-point lead. 29 reach. Page picks up a couple. We spot it at the 24. And who's in the middle there plugging away? Mr. Banks. Riverside just went up 23-17 on a deep pass, pending the extra point. Screen to Starling, and he's wrapped up Tonga wrapping up in space on an easy player to tackle. And we fold our cameraman on the middle screen. Third down and two. Five on the play clock. And a stop. Katonga and Fred Tompkins. This is what you do when your defensive line plays strong along the line of scrimmage. Let the linebackers run free. And that's exactly what happened. Neither one was blocked on that play. And that means the defensive front is holding up the offensive line. And that's a result. Holloway is deep. Heels on the 40-yard line of CSM. The Rams blocked the punt in the first matchup. They're going to go punt return here. Good kick. Holloway with a fair catch, and he'll take it on his own 40-yard line. So the defense for both teams have stepped up incredibly here in the second half. Only a 31-yard field goal by Hill. That's the lone score of the second half. 1 in at running back behind Newman. So Riverside up now 24-17 down in Southern California. Bootleg. Newman throws. Weimer catch complete. First down, or just short, depending on the spot. That's a first down. So, little naked right by Newman, keeps running. Weimer across the formation, makes the catch. Showing an edge blitzer at the top of your screen. Newman possibly changing the play. And it's a sack. His 7th sack of the season. Lavallo gets home, but then we've got a flag. And we'll see what the call is. It's a holding on the Rams. I would imagine Coach Tulloch will decline this penalty. Because it'll be 2nd and 13. The hole didn't help. So it'll be 2nd down and 13. The Rams will be playing behind the chains. Watch number 9. I mean, the tackle got beat inside, and then Walker didn't know if he wanted to chop block him. Been better just yelling, look out! 2nd and 13. Newman out in the flat to Walker. Look at the effort here. Janiel has got a chance to make a play out here in space. But Walker, with a can-do attitude and refusing to be taken down by the first defender, right there, breaks several tackles and picks up extra yardage to make it an imaginable 3rd and 7. Two-by-two set. Weimer getting pressed at the bottom of your screen. Rams will take a shot on 3rd and 7. Don't mean they're just going to the chains, and there's a shot right there. And it's incomplete. Great coverage. Playing the football, not the man. So So this is what sports and athletics and football are all about. Janiel just missed a tackle, right? Comes back next play and makes a great play. So goes next play. You don't play perfect. You play hard. You keep doing your job. And Janiel does a great job of getting the pass defense on the corner route. And another punt for the Rams. Lampley, very lethal back there. Angled out. See, well, this will be spotted at the 15. And it'll be first down and 10 with 9 minutes and 7 seconds left in regulation for CSM on their own 15. Dubliner West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights, and foggier mornings. Dubliner West Portal. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 65 years in San Francisco. Stock up for celebrations with family and friends. Mitchell's Ice Cream. Doesn't that sound good now? A little pistachio on a cone? I digress. Batari, play pass, has a lot of time. Throw late to Starling, and it's completed for nearly about a 14-yard gain. Starling, once again, all the way across the formation. He lined up as an X receiver on the left, just keeps coming across the formation. And when you give Batari that much time, it's tough ask to expect the defense to cover Starling for that long. First and 10 at the 29. Another play pass. Batari scrambles out to this right, a little shovel pass. Pick up about 6. He was intended to go downfield. Didn't like the coverage by the Rams. And then just a little check down to Evans. Right there. And short, a nice gain on first down. 6 yards, 2nd and 4. Page. Actually, that's Evans with the carry. Picks up maybe 1. And it'll be 3rd down and 4. Joshua Scott came up from his corner position with the play. 3rd and 3. Short pass. The Rams blitz. Batari is not going to. He gets there, and that'll move the chains. Look at the effort by the quarterback. Good pass rush that time by the Rams, but they get a little bit out of their rushing lanes. And the leading touchdown thrower in the history of CSM football makes a great play. See, right there, they lose contain. And then a missed tackle at the 35-yard line gets it out to the 40, and it's another CSM first down. Throw out in the flat and fumble, said he's on the ground. Sincere Jackson on the coverage. They'll give him the completion and a 1 yard gain. Vertically and horizontally stretching the defense. It'll be 2nd and 9. Late substitution for City College. Clock's running here. Play pass. Batari dumps it off. Great decision to Evans. He gets a first down and more. So when you're man-to-man coverage, or zone, and the time, you're just going to continue to sink. Good coverage downfield, but Evans kind of gets lost in the behind the wash, and then with the catch and gets immediately upfield, and it's another first down for the Bulldogs. They're in Ram territory at the 46. Quick pass by Batari, and it's intercepted. You test and test and test, but when you lead the state in interception, eventually you're going to take care of the test, and that's exactly what Greeley did. Had an interception for a touchdown last week. That's his ninth interception of the season. So the Bulldogs were driving, picking up chunks. Then they test the waters one more time of Greeley. And he hasn't had his best day, but it doesn't matter. It ends, matters what happens at the end and with the pickoff. Walker, two-yard loss. Latulu again. So each team has turned the football over twice. Second and 12. Empty backfield. Second time the Rams have been in this formation. Newman runs. He's hammered. Fumbles. No, they're calling him down. They're calling him down. Newman will pick up the first down, and the CSM coaching staff is beside themselves. You be the judge. He was down. The ball wasn't dislodged on the tackle. The ball was dislodged when he hit the turf. Good call by the officials. So that'll wind the clock. Big first down. Late substitution for the Rams. They got to make sure they got the right play on here. Play clock at 5, 4, 3. Inside run to Walker, and he picks up maybe one. Newman with the 12-yard scramble. Lost the football, but it was on the caused by the ground. Second and 9. This usually isn't a bad time to throw the football, and usually a great time to throw the football to the tight end. Second and 9. Play pass. Weimers. First down. Time and time and time again this season, number 80. He's like 7-11, open all day and open all night with the big catch over the middle. Comes all the way across the formation. Newman hits him, gets up the field, and makes the play. The state's leading receiver, receptions, yards, and touchdowns, and he hasn't disappointed today. 3 minutes here from George M. Rush Stadium. Zimmerman in motion. Walker. And Coach Tolick will call a timeout. It'll be 2nd and 7 after the timeout. And we'll keep it right here. Appreciate all of our partners. And also, we want to say thank you to Mia Blank, who's the assistant to head coach Jimmy Collins. She's been so helpful in us bringing you this game and is such a great asset to this football program. City College of San Francisco football. Learn more about the 10-time national champion Rams at ccsfathletics.com. City College of San Francisco football, a tradition of winning. The Gold Mirror Italian restaurant, where the neighborhood goes to take a time out to share classic cocktails and a great meal with family and friends. American Asphalt, taking care of business in Northern California for over 35 years. Dubliner West Portal, so many victories, so many celebratory drinks, foggy nights and foggier mornings. Mitchell's Ice Cream, celebrating over 65 years in San Francisco. Stock up for celebrations with family and friends. RVC Showcase, the greatest showcase in the world. Go to rvcshowcase.com. So it'll be 2nd and 7, 2:59 left. Rams lead CSM 20-17. Down south, Riverside is up 27-17 with less than 3 minutes left in the game. So it appears that the winner of this game will play at Riverside next Saturday. Both teams have 2 timeouts. 3-by-1 set. Walker, nice cut. And just short of the first down, and the Bulldogs will call their 2nd timeout of the game. Walker, this is what we call in football the 4-minute offense, even though they took the ball with 5:30 plus left in the game. You get the yards you deserve. Don't struggle for extra yards. Stay in bounds and move the chains. And on this drive, that's exactly what the Rams have done. Now, the last time it was 3rd and 1, it was 3rd and 1 down here in the goal, near the goal line, and the Rams try to run a halfback pass that didn't work so well, and they were forced to kick a field goal, which is right now the difference of this football game. Both quarterbacks have thrown 2 interceptions each. Batari threw 2 interceptions in the first matchup. And right now, if you're CSM, you want to tackle and then tackle the football all at the same time, trying to get a chicken strip. The Rams trying to get back to a place where they once belonged. 2:48 left. 3rd and 1. First down. 29-yard line. And Coach Tolick will call his final timeout of the game. Walker with the forward lean. 5'9", 180-pound sophomore with those pin and pull runs today and maintaining possession of the football. Been a defensive battle, in particular here in the second half. Want to thank both coaches for their help in preparing for this broadcast. Hopefully it reflected in that. And City College of San Francisco Athletic Director Harold Brown meeting us here nice and early and allowing us to get set up. And again, both coaches and 2 quality programs here. And what these teams have endured the last 20 months is way beyond the scope of me to discuss or even explain, but tip of the hat to both programs and all of JUCO football in California. 1st and 10. Hold on. Bulldogs are going to tackle the football, try to strip it from Walker. He just dives ahead and maybe gets a yard. So there's 40 seconds in between snaps. So they won't have to snap this ball until less than 2 minutes left in the quarter. No timeouts for San Mateo. They cannot stop the clock. ...27-23 down in Southern California. Walker and company. Walker tackled for no gain. Third and nine. Have to snap this around the 120 mark. And the question is, do the Rams go for it if they don't pick it up here? Because this is a possibly beyond Hill's longest field goal this year is only 36 yards. Newman's got a little bit of time to let this clock go down just a little further. Now they'll snap it. Five on the play clock. Inside zone. And that won't get the first down, but it'll be fourth down and three. So they won't have to snap this ball until under 30 seconds, and they get the first down. It'll be game. Coach Collins, he's going to let this play clock drain all the way down and then call a timeout, and then they'll discuss and run their best fourth and three play. He's standing right next to the line judge watching the play clock. He's going to let everything drain down. Be called right around 26 second mark. Well, there goes my Chico State math. We'll call it 28 seconds, and it calls the timeout. So situational football. Both these teams practice it consistently. Coaches will put time on the clock and say, okay, we're up 3 points and it's fourth and three. We're down 3 points and it's fourth and three and we're on defense. What are you going to do? I would expect some type of run, but you don't have to run the football. You could pass the ball because the clock's going to stop. I mean, the game here is getting 3 yards. And one of the keys is be aggressive, be us, and we'll see what Coach Collins has up his sleeve for this play. We appreciate everybody who's watching this game and follow us on social media at NorCal Sports TV. And subscribe to where you're watching this football game absolutely free, live with replay. I might annoy you, but that's okay. YouTube.com/NorCal Sports TV. I'm Chris Babcock. We're here at George M. Rush Stadium for a berth for the state championship. Newman, play clock down to 10, down to 9. And Coach Collins calls back-to-back timeouts. It's like a Zoom meeting gone bad. We all love our Zoom meetings, don't we? So neither team has any timeouts left. They've got the wide side of the field if they want to run a little sprint out or maybe a little naked and slip Zimmerman out to the flat, the tight end who had a nice game against the Bulldogs the first time they played in November. But as we had mentioned early in the game, 10 of the last 15 games between these schools have been decided by 6 or less points. CSM trying to make it three in a row at CCSF when they came here today. But the Rams have just been a little bit better here in the second half. Golden West with the football. They trail by four. Here's the ball game. You get a stop, CSM will get the football back. They get the first down, it'll be victory formation. Newman in the shotgun. Has time. Throws. Complete. Ball game.
Let's go! Let's go, Aaron!
Aaron Espero with the catch. And the clock will run, and that'll close it out. So as we mentioned in our opening, get back, get back, get back to where you once belonged. And the City College of San Francisco Rams will get back to the state championship for the first time since 2015 with the 20-17 victory over College of San Mateo. I know these we didn't want this game to end. We were so honored to come here and cover this game. But what a football game. And the Rams with the winning the second half, 3-0, and when they had the football and they needed to go into four-minute offense at the end of the game, that's exactly what they did. It's the 2021 CCCA Northern California Football Finals on NorCal Sports TV, presented by City College of San Francisco Football. All right. Do I want to try to get an interview down there? I don't think we're really geared for it, are we? I can't really get a signal from anybody, like a point.
Your restaurant keeps rich in tradition by making its own pastas and desserts. Our classic entrees include veal, homemade pastas, and fresh fish. Located at 800 Terrivol Street on the corner of 18th Avenue in San Francisco. The Gold Mirror is open Wednesday through Sunday for dinner and cocktails. Go to goldmirrorsf.com. That's goldmirrorsf.com to learn more about this iconic restaurant that has been serving San Francisco for over 50 years. Gold Mirror Italian Restaurant remains a haven from the fast pace of everyday life, where the neighborhood goes to take a time out and share classic cocktails and a great meal with friends and family.
One thing about these games that I have to warn you about.
Yes.
The ups and the downs. You're up 30 and it's tied within a second. You're down 30 and tied within a field just like that.
Know this. This is the best football team in the United States.
So City College of San Francisco is the most successful junior college football program in the history of the United States. We've won more championships, more conference championships. We've scholarshiped more players to every level, but we've in particular scholarshiped more players to the Division I level than any other junior college in the entire country.
We are the winningest college football program in America since 1990.
Our winning percentage since 1990 is over 89%. When you come here, we're gonna create opportunities that you didn't have coming out of high school or coming from your previous college. When you come to City College of San Francisco, a whole new world of opportunities open to you.
Some great, great players here, they got their second opportunity to get themselves into the next level.
There's very few junior colleges where legacy and alma mater pride, so to speak, is as important as it is here. People that play here, they talk about their time at City College, or even more commonly referred to simply as City. There's a lot of City Colleges around the country, but when you say City, people know it's San Francisco.
City College of San Francisco is a very, very special place.
And it's because of the football program and the legacy of the people that have come before.
It has a legacy that goes all the way to, 75 years plus.
We've had a Heisman Trophy winner. We've had countless players in the NFL, Super Bowl champions. And everyone who comes to City College wants to play here because they want to be a part of the history and the legacy that this program has.
And we have such a diverse team, kids from all kinds of realms, culturally, financially, socially, and they all come together here.
We have a $100 million athletic center that rivals any Division I facility you will find that is less than 10 years old. Every resource you need is here for you to succeed. The legacy is unrivaled, and now you have an opportunity to compete at the highest level of junior college football.
Have a little fun today, Coach?
As fun as we've had in a long time. Can't get better than that.
What did we talk about last night and then a little text, the motivational text this morning?
Back to where you once returned. Back where you once were from, man.
Get back to where you once belong. Your first season as head coach, you got into the state championship game. Quality opponent in CSM, a familiar opponent. You did just enough to get the victory.
That's it. It's just the quality of the kids we have is amazing. Our coaching staff, it just says so much about the perseverance we've showed the last couple years. We've been just short. We've been a play away in these championship games. Today, we had to make a play, and we made it, and that ended the game. Our defense needed to make plays. They shut them out in the second half. They're driving. Dre Greeley with, I think, his ninth interception of the year. It's just all we talked about at halftime was we didn't have a field all year. We had COVID. We haven't had a team meeting indoors. All we've done is had challenge after challenge after challenge, and these kids answer it every time. And we said at halftime, if the challenge is go play our brand of football, that's what we're going to do. And they did, and we won. It's that easy.
Well, the thing that I was impressed about today with Greeley is that they went after him all day long. And when he needed to make a play on a 50-50 ball, we always have been talking these last couple weeks about 50-50 balls, he was there to make that play.
It's this win embodies who we are as a program, from head to toe, from our inactive players through the leadership of our college and everyone in between. Times have been tough, and we have faced, and the college is still running. We're playing sports right now. We were the first back because of COVID. We're getting unbelievable support from the administration. They're going to support us on this trip down south, and the guys, that's who our kids are. We don't get our scrimmage gets canceled. We got to play here because of fire. It's one thing after the other.
Yep.
And all they do is say, yes, coach, and they get it done. And when they need to make a play, time in and time out, made a play. Aaron Asparo today, Jack Newman, just phenomenal. And Jeff.
Sparrow, I think on his resume, I just read it was updated in Wikipedia. It said chain mover. I mean.
I'll say right now. I walked into our staff meeting on Monday, said Aaron Sparrow is going to be the player of the game this weekend. I think he was. That catch in the end zone, that catch to end the game, some of the plays he made, it was just big time. Big time. Thanks.
Coach, we appreciate everything with the program, and we'll be back with more City College of San Francisco football on NorCal Sports TV. Well, we're going to close things up here from George M. Rush Stadium, where City College of San Francisco beat CSM 20-17 to move on to the CCCAA State Championship next Saturday. And they'll be playing at Riverside next Saturday, a time to be determined. Thanks to both head coaches who helped us prepare for this game, Tim Tulloch and Jimmy Collins. Push a special tip of the hat to Mia Blank, assistant to head coach here at CCSF, for helping us secure partners for this game. We ask once again, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/NorCalSportsTV, for alerts of upcoming games. You've been watching NorCal Sports TV. Thanks to our crew, Jason Brown, Vincent Kelly, and our director, Jason Green. I'm Chris Babcock here in San Francisco. Good afternoon. And thanks for being on the show.